the comma operator. Comma operator can be overloaded. Let's see how to do it. So the default operation of the comma operator is, it basically causes the sequence of operations. Sequence of operations. One example, in the right hand side, when you write variables, okay. So in the before the assignment operator, we write some variables. Then all the variables one by one will be assigned to the target signal. So when it is RHS of an assignment statement, the value assigned is the value of the last assigned expression of the comma separated list. Okay. So do this and this like that. Now, in the overloaded comma operator, what we'll do is discard the values of all operands. Discard the value of all operands. In a normal way, one by one, it will assign the value. Then finally, the right one will be assigned. The last one will be then assigned. Whereas in overloading comma operator, what will happen? It discards all the values of the operands. Only the whatever the rightmost will be result of the comma operation will be assigned to the target signal. In that way, we can say. Okay. Now, let's see a simple program here. So this program is to overload the comma operator. You can see that I have called the class name as comma, and having two variables x and y of private section. In the public, you have two member functions. But looking at these member functions, these are all not as simple member functions. These are all constructors. Okay. So same class names are there, right? So it's a constructor. This is a default constructor and this is a parameterized constructor. The default constructor, the x and y values are 0. In a parameterized constructor, the a and b value will be passed to the x and y respectively. Okay. Next, overloading the comma operator. What it will do? Comma is the class name. Okay. That's going to be the written data type. This is the construct. Then this is the operator that we are going to overload. Comma operator. Then within bracket, we are going to take input as an argument. Input argument as an object. So, comma object 1. Okay. Then also being intermediate, we need one object, so that object 2 is declared here. So object will be equal to object 1.x. So through object 1 value will be given, that will be passed to the object 2.x. Whatever the value that's given to y will be passed to the y object of 2. Okay. Then it returns a value. So this object will have what value? X and y value. Here we have a x and here we have a y value. Then, so there is one show member function which will take an argument. From the argument, it will show the x and y value of a argumented object. Okay. Now what will happen? Now main program. You can see that here. Main comma is the class name. Then one object called object 3, it is initialized with the value 5 and 10. So x of the object 3 will be 5 and y of object 3 will be 10. Then x of object 4 will be 20 and y of object 4 will be 30. Then x of object 5 will be 100, y of object 5 will be 150. You see that now, this is what we called as a constructor statement, object construction. So here you can see that object 3 is initialized with 3 objects, object 3, object 4, object 5. But ultimately if you look into it, only object 5 will be loaded onto the object 3. So when you sprint it, what is the value of object 5 under C, you will be able to see, okay, in object 3, you will be able to see the x and y value of object 5 only will be displayed on the screen. Okay, you can see the output here. So when I run the program, although many objects are given and assigned in the right hand side, but when it executes, it takes only the last argument, last object. Okay. So in object 5, what we had x equal to 100, y is equal to 150. So in object 3 also, we'll be having x is equal to 100, y is equal to 50. Understand? So this way, we can overload the comma operator. Okay. So just it overrides the basic semantics. Then return 0 terminates the main program. Got it? Okay. Thank you.